Hello and welcome to the episode 243 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we'll see the Beatles playing a number of live engagements, discover how they spent their days off in 1964, and catch Dylan playing live. Let's start the episode with the continuation of the residency of the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums and Stu Sutcliffe on bass, at the Indra Club in Hamburg, West Germany. It was the 31st of August 1960. Exactly 1 year later, in 1961, the Beatles, now with Paul McCartney on bass, performed at the St. John's Hall in Liverpool for another night organized by Mona Best, Pete's mother. In 1962, the Beatles performed at the Lydney Town Hall in Lydney, Gloucestershire, for the first of two engagements with JB Clubs. It was part of their manager Brian Epstein's plan to allow the band to get more visibility and dates in the south of England. No such problem in 1963. On this date, the Beatles performed the last of six nights at the Odeon Cinema in Southport, with their mind probably already turned to the next day's filming of yet another TV appearance. On the 31st of August 1964, instead, the Fabs enjoyed the first of 2 days off from their ongoing first North American tour, staying at the Marquise de Lafayette Hotel in Cape May, New Jersey, close to Atlantic City. It wasn't much of an experience, given that the four were forced to spend the time alone, locked in their hotel room, because of the fans besieging the premises. Regardless, something good came from the 2 days of isolation. During their stay at the hotel, John and Paul wrote Every Little Thing and What You're Doing, both gracing the Beatles' For Sale album, recorded further down the line, as we will see. In 1965, we get the 10th and final date of the Beatles' 1965 North American tour, with two performances at the Cow Palace in San Francisco, California. As we saw in episode 231, this was the venue that opened the 1964 tour. The matinee show was attended by 11,700 people, while the evening one by 17,000 people. In between the shows, the Beatles gave a press conference and met John Baez and Johnny Cash in the backstage. The second performance was interrupted when fans managed to break through the barriers and jump on the stage. In 1967, the Beatles issued a press statement about NEMS Enterprises and their plans to handle their future after the death of their manager Brian Epstein. See episode 239 for more info on that. The four explained that they would keep their relationship with NEMS Enterprises until further notice, but that they would not be personally managed by Clive Epstein, Brian's brother, because, as Paul McCartney said, no one could possibly replace Brian. The Beatles also made clear that they would have been willing to put money into NEMS if there ever was a question of a takeover from other parties, and that they would have kept their quota of NEMS shares. Finally, in 1969, George Harrison, John Lennon, Ringo Starr and their spouses Patty Harrison, Yoko Ono and Maureen Starkey attended the show closing the Isle of Wight Festival, featuring Bob Dylan and the band. Mixed with them, in the 150,000-strong crowd, Keith Richards, Bill Wyman, Syd Barrett, Eric Clapton, Elton John and Jane Fonda. The three Beatles met Dylan after the concert in a rented farmhouse and gave him an acetate copy of Abbey Road. And now it's time to head to www.simonmas.com/support and see what you can do to help our little community to grow stronger. Thanks to your messages, shares and tips, I will be able to follow up on this podcast with a nice video series or two. The plans are already on the table and you can be instrumental to make it happen. Thank you. Tomorrow we will get live shows, TV appearances and plotting about the future. Don't miss it out. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.